Hello everyone, I am Dr. Ahmet Ergin, founder of SugarMDs.com. Now, today we are going to talk about hypoglycemia symptoms. What is hypoglycemia? It is low blood sugar. It's the medical definition for low blood sugar. So, how do you feel when you have low blood sugar? A lot of people do not know how do they really feel. So, sometimes you may feel dizzy and irritable, and you may not even know why you feel that way. You may think that your personality is changing, but it could be your low blood sugar. So let's review the symptoms of hypoglycemia, which is low blood sugar, right now. And in the next video, we will talk about how to treat this, okay? So it is divided into two. Number one is adrenergic symptoms. So why do we call this adrenergic symptoms? Because it comes from your adrenal gland. It is adrenaline induced. So when you have low blood sugar, your body gives a panic reaction and it releases adrenaline response. So it's the same reaction when you see a lion in the middle of a forest. What do you feel like? Your heart race, your heart is gonna race, you're gonna start shaking, you're gonna start sweating, unless you're a hero or some sort, right? So if you're like face to face with a lion, you're secreting a bunch of adrenaline. And then next thing you know, you need to run, right? So you need to get pumped up for the energy to run. Now your body does not differentiate between this fear response or hypoglycemia response. It is a panic response. So when your blood sugars are going low, your adrenaline goes up and that gives you excessive sweating. You may feel hot, you may feel shaky, your heart may race. And all these symptoms are, we call them adrenergic symptoms. So it may be subtle as well. If your blood sugars are not down to 30, but let's say you are down to 70, you may actually feel like, oh, I kind of feel hot. Hey, do you feel hot? Do you feel hot? Everybody's like, no, I'm fine. Then it's better for you to check your blood sugars, right? And then suddenly you may feel like, you know, what's going on? I'm kind of clammy, I'm sweaty, you know, kind of irritable. You know, you may want to check your blood sugar at that time. So don't wait, don't think twice. Check your blood sugar if you doubt about it. Now, the second part of symptoms could be neurological. So sometimes neurological symptoms are subtle, and it could be just dizziness. It can be irritability, as we discussed. It can be just a little bit of a confusion or a foggy mind. Then, you know, that these symptoms are considered neurological symptoms and you may want to check your blood sugars. If it is really severe and if your blood sugar drops really low suddenly, then you may actually feel like that you may not be able to do anything. So sometimes people will have, for example, total disability. So you may be able to see, but you may not be able to hear. Or you may be able to hear, but you may not be able to speak. These are disabling symptoms. Sometimes you know that you have a low blood sugar and you need to fix it, right? You may want to grab something sweet, but your body may not allow you to do that. So you may be almost paralyzed. In the worst case scenario, you may totally pass out. And that's called severe hypoglycemia. So these are the severe neurological symptoms. Sometimes, you know, you may have seen this in your relatives as well. They will zoom out. They may not be able to respond to you. And if they are feeling weird, behaving weird, you better check their blood sugar. So because at that point, if you're the patient, you're not gonna be able to help yourself. So also educate others of what a hypoglycemia is and how it feels like so that they know. So this happened actually, my mother has diabetes and one time she had a low blood sugar and she was trying to tell my father but she wasn't able to. So I really hate hypoglycemia because I know how it feels. I hear all the time from people how it feels. So you need to immediately recognize the symptoms of hypoglycemia in order to treat and get out of it. Now in the next video, we are going to talk about how to treat hypoglycemia. There are a lot of misconceptions and mistakes people do all the time for treating hypoglycemia. So give a thumbs up to this video and we'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.